Hello, class 10th students, greetings of the day. This is lecture 7 of our chapter 3, first phase of Indian National Movement. In last lecture, we studied about Dadabhai Naoroji, one of the prominent leader of early phase of national movement. Now we are going to study about the second leader who was also very prominent leader during the early phase of national movement. And he was Gopal Krishna Gokhale, who is also called the political guru or political mentor of Gandhiji. So we will study about Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Gopal Krishna Gokhale took birth in Kolhapur in Maharashtra. In 1866, then he worked as history and economics professor at Ferguson College, and then after that he joined the Deccan Society, which was founded by Mahatma Govind Ranade, M.G. Ranade. This Deccan Society, Mahatma Govind Ranade was one of the very prominent social reformer of Maharashtra. Right, so Gopal Krishna Gokhale joined his society, Deccan Society, and through this society only he was sent to England, right, England, to present his views on Welby Commission. So he presented his views of India before Welby Commission. Welby Commission we have already studied. Lord Welby and Lord Sherman, they were when Welby Commission was set up to look into the British expenses or British over expenses, okay, that we have studied in last videos. Then he was given a title CIE, Companion of Indian Empire, okay, Companion of Indian Empire. Then after that he became the president of Indian National Congress during the Varanasi session in 1905, okay, in 1905 when the partition took place, okay. So in that session which was organized in Varanasi, he became the president. And then after that he was moderate leader. He sought the self rule under the aegis of the government, like the other colonies like Australia were having, okay. So but even then he criticized the unjust policies of Britishers, like the huge expenditure on army and on military forces, okay, and the racial discrimination which was being done by the Britishers, and the production tax on cotton, okay. So against these things, then he also advocated separation of judiciary from executive, okay, that we have studied in last lectures, that okay, one of the demand of early nationalist was to bring administrative reforms, and in that they demanded separation of judiciary from the executive, okay. And then Morley Minto reforms were there in 1909, which is also called the Government of India Act of 1909, and also Morley Minto reforms. So Morley Minto reforms were passed due to his efforts only, and then he became member of IPSC. He became the member of Indian Public Service Commission. Now, what was Indian Public Service Commission? Indian Public Service Commission used to appoint the civil servants, okay. And then he joined Servants of India Society in 1905. And then Servants of India Society was a social society, just like Red Cross or other societies are there which work for the social reforms, okay. So that was also that society. And then after that he became member of Imperial Legislative Council. We have studied in last lectures that okay, representation, Indian representation was demanded by the early nationalists, okay. And due to their efforts only, the Council of India Act of 1892 was passed. And then He became the member of that Imperial Legislative Council, and being the member of Imperial Legislative Council, he demanded abolition of salt duty. He criticized the cotton goods duty, and he also convinced Britishers to finish the toll taxes. Okay, and he also put forward compulsory primary education bill. Okay, like today we are having primary education, compulsory primary education, right? Likewise, he put the bill, okay, compulsory primary education bill, but it was not passed. Then he became the political mentor and guru of Gandhiji. He convinced Gandhiji to return to India and take participation in the Indian national movement. Okay, and then on 15th of February 1915, he died. Okay, he passed away from this world. Thank you so much.